interpretations. ABG, arterial blood gases, are blood readings to tell us about the body's pH. They're drawn by respiratory therapy, usually from the radial arterial line. But the numbers that pop up, we read, interpret, and then report to the RN or the doctor. It's concerning two systems that act as a buffering system for the body to maintain homeostasis. The first system are the lungs, which have CO2, which is an acid. The second system, kidneys, which has sodium bicarbonate, yes, just like baking soda, and it's a base, or you can call it alkaline. When we're talking about the blood pH, normal that you remember from anatomy is 7.35 to 7.45. It's normal blood pH. If we deviate either way, we'll die. So, our body has these two systems that buffer, meaning they try to say, okay, we're going past below 7.35. We need to take action to bring us back within this range. The lungs have their own system. It's the CO2, and they have the reading of 35 to 45. The HCO3 have their own system. It's 22 to 26. However, it's not what you think. So yes, while 7.35 and below is acidic, and 7.45 above is basic or alkaline. It's opposite for CO2, because CO2 is an acid already. So the higher, the more CO2 you have, the more acidic you're gonna become. So if it's above 45, you're gonna have more acid. And if it's below 35, you're gonna be more basic or more alkaline. HCO3 is a base. So again, if you have more, you're gonna be alkaline or more basic. And if you have below, you're gonna be more acid. I know it sounds confusing. So I've come up with this ABBA-BAB, and you will need to memorize this. If you don't memorize this, you'll never learn how to interpret it. Memorize. Because this is where it's gonna come in handy when we start to read. So the respiratory therapy has drawn the blood and has brought you a numbered reading. What do I do with this? What do I do with these numbers? I'm gonna follow two easy steps and find out what is wrong with my patient. So we're going to do this example. Step one, read the pH. Sounds simple enough, but the pH is our key to the entire body. So the blood pH that's circulating around our patient is going to tell us if they're too much acid, too much base. So 7.27 is below 7.35, so therefore it is an acid. Then I go and put acidosis on my answer. Step two, match the abnormality. Okay, I'm gonna start bottom up this time. HCO3, the baking soda, the base, 24. That's within normal range. 50 is above 45. So therefore it's an acid. The pH and the CO2 are both abnormal. The CO2 came from my lungs, so it's respiratory. So it has respiratory acidosis. So my patient is in respiratory acidosis.
Action.
So another example of ABG interpretation is this. pH 7.50, so it's above, so it's a base. Let's work bottom up again. HCO3 is 20, it's not normal, but it's an acid. So it does not match the key. CO2 is 30, which is a base. It matches. So therefore, our answer is going to be respiratory again. But it's respiratory alkalosis. Meaning my body has too much base, but it's a problem from my lungs, not from my kidneys. So that's where we get the respiratory alkalosis, because it's too much base.
Action.
Another example, pH 7.30 below, so it's acid. CO2 40, that falls within our normal range, so it's normal. HCO3 20, so it's below, so it's acid. Because it's from our kidneys, it's metabolic. Okay, this pH 7.50 above 7.45, so it's alkaline. CO2, it's acid, does not match. 28 out of range, but it's basic. These two match. It's coming from HCO3, meaning it's metabolic. So it's metabolic alkalosis.
Action.
All right. So now that we learned how to read the numbers of the ABGs, now we need to know the four disorders that could be the cause of the abnormality in the numbers. So the first one, respiratory acidosis, the cause is something that causes hypoventilation. So it could be something like pneumonia. It could be something like a drug overdose. Something that's going to cause you to retain CO2. CO2 is an acid. You have too much acid. What is our patient going to look like? They're going to be tachycardic. Have a headache, sweating, lethargy. You need to check their mental status, do maybe hourly neuro checks. And the treatment, we have to increase their O2. So first of all, we're gonna do patient positioning, deep breathing. If it is something, an infective process, we need to do antibiotics, bronchodilators, and they may end up getting intubated. That's the end result. With respiratory alkalosis, something is causing them to hyperventilate because they're losing their CO2. They're losing their acid, they're becoming more basic. So one of the causes, the main causes, are nursing students go into respiratory alkalosis all the time before they open up a nursing test. They're too anxious. They start breathing. Another cause is could be congestive heart failure, or even a fever, because people with fevers start to get tachypneic, tachycardic, irritable. They may have muscle weakness, and then paresthesia, numbing or tingling of the fingers. Nursing treatment for respiratory alkalosis may include pursed lip breathing, because you want to retain the CO2, and paper bag breathing, where you're having someone breathe through a paper bag, because as they're breathing out, the CO2 is sitting in the bottom of the paper bag and they are rebreathing CO2 to get them out of alkalosis. And then it may be sedation, so they may order sedatives and we would have to administer that. Metabolic alkalosis, the cause could be prolonged NG suctioning. So if you're suctioning continuously the stomach acid, you could throw yourself into a base state. Excess vomiting, kind of the same line. You're getting rid of too much acid in your body. You're becoming into a basic state. Diuretics and a massive blood transfusion would also throw you into metabolic alkalosis. Our patient would have a headache, irritability, mental status change, Cheney-Stokes respiration, so respirations with periods of apnea, and then hyperactive reflexes, so like our chopsticks and trousseau's reflexes. We would want to make sure that we maintain daily eyes and O's, especially if there are excess vomiting, diuretics. So we keep strict eyes and O's and fluid calculations on them. And then we have our metabolic acidosis. This is commonly, this is actually what happens most of the time when somebody finds out they're diabetic, because the classic cause is DKA, diabetic ketoacidosis. And it's causing you to breathe really fast, and you're not getting good ventilation or good respiration either. So you actually see Kussmaul's respirations. Another one is renal failure will cause metabolic acidosis, and then dehydration. So you want to check their mental status again. They may have nausea and vomiting, and then a big one also is the cardiac dysrhythmias. For these people, if it's severe enough, they'll actually infuse sodium bicarbonate and then potentially intubate them.